So we're here today with Southfield Mayor Ken Siver, who is running for reelection on November 7th. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well, and how about you?
Good. Thank you so much for coming out. Can you talk a little bit about what has been sort of your history on council and some of your accomplishments?
Well, I'm a 50-year resident of the city. I've always been involved, particularly on the neighborhood level. I've been on the Magnolia Neighborhood Board since 1974. And I was a teacher and then administrator in the Southfield Public Schools. I had a 45-year career in the school district. And over the years, I was involved in any number of city committees, everything from getting out the people that get counted on the various censuses to a visioning session we had, Southfield 2020. Worked in numerous environmental causes, particularly tree planting and recycling over the years. And in 2001, I was elected to city council, re-elected in 2005, 9, and 13. And then in 2015, I ran for mayor and was successful in that. And I've had a great run these past 2 years. And I credit a lot of that to doing a vision session with the council and team building. We all get along, and when people get along, more things get done.
You don't have an opponent in this race, so you will be continuing as mayor. What are some of the things that you'll be working on in the next couple of years?
Well, we have a whole series of goals. 40-some, and they were short and long-term goals. And they fall into a number of categories, and in no particular order. One of them is infrastructure. We have been leading Oakland County for the last 3 years in the amount of road construction that's taken place. We get a lot of complaints in the winter about potholes, and in construction season or orange barrel season, people say, "Oh, I can't get around." But I think people are going to find this winter that it's much more pleasant to drive on Southfield streets, as we've done a tremendous amount of road work. With the exception of some of the county roads, like 10 Mile, that are not our roads. But anyhow, so we have roads, and also that includes sewers and water lines. We've rebuilt almost every single bridge in the city. We have one more to do. That'll be done next year. Redevelopment is another big area we're working on. Obviously, the biggest project we've ever undertaken is Northland. And we've owned Northland Mall for about 22 months. And in that time, a tremendous amount has happened, although the mall is still standing. First of all, we had to consolidate the properties. We had to secure the properties. And then we did all this environmental testing. And as this interview is being conducted, we're finishing up on asbestos and hazardous material removal. We also, over the years with the development of the mall and selling off of outlot parcels, there are a tremendous number of easements. Matter of fact, 870 pages worth of easements that comprise about 33 major easements, but they're very detailed. So in order to redevelop the property, obviously we have to have clear title and clear the easements. We're also working, we've vetted now the contractors for demolition. Demolition should start the first phase of demolition in November. Our other big redevelopment project is the parcel across the street from Southfield City Hall. We are interested in making that into a mixed-use development with residences, retail, restaurants, a small hotel, and a park and parking garage. Another area that we're doing a lot of work in is business retention and attraction. We've had a tremendous gain in businesses coming to or moving into Southfield in the last year. And there's been a net gain of over 2,500 jobs just in the last year alone. That's tremendous. And why is that important? It's important because we have 29 million square feet of office space. 60% of our tax base is based on our commercial properties. We have to keep those towers full. Our vacancy rate has declined considerably in our office sector. This is really good news. And also, when you think about people being here, then obviously they're shopping here, they're eating here, they're using hotels here, gas stations, etc. It's a good spinoff to our economy. We're also working very diligently on creating more of a sense of place. Southfield was the city developed around the automobile. It was a boom town in the 50s and 60s, and so we're trying to soften that with more non-motorized pathways, bike paths. We have a bike share program now. We have we've widened sidewalks. We've added miles of new sidewalks where none existed. We're encouraging walkability and walking or biking. And we are also working on a sense of place. I have a large public art initiative that we're moving right along on. As people know, we did not allow the Northland Art Collection. It was set to be auctioned off when the mall went into receivership, and we ended up raising the money of over $600,000 to purchase the art and begin its restoration and placement. And finally, of course, I'm very much into neighborhood revitalization. Our housing stock, 50, 60, 70 years old, we have to reinvest in our neighborhood. And we're doing that kind of block by block, house by house, with a number of initiatives, including our partnerships with Oakland Rebuilding Together and Habitat for Humanity's Rock the Block program. Southfield Parks and Garden Club also, and a number of corporate sponsors from Federal Mogul, Eaton, Comcast, and others. We've done the last couple of years a whole number of home restorations that are done by volunteers. These are occupied houses. And then we have our neighborhood reinvestment initiative, where we take foreclosed properties, and actually this is done with a partnership with the Habitat for Humanity and the Southfield Reinvestment Initiative, or what we call NRI, and some 100 homes are being rehabbed in this program, and they are being sold at market value, so property values are going up. That's the goal of this. And they cannot be rentals. The houses are sold. If you can get a mortgage, you can buy one of these houses, and they're with the stipulation you have to live in it. You cannot not rent the house.
So you are running unopposed for this seat. Why should people still come out and vote?
Well, I think it's important as a candidate not to take the voter for granted. I have always campaigned. I'll say this, honestly, I'm not working as hard at campaigning, but I am campaigning. I am out in the neighborhoods, I'm at events, and we're doing typical campaign things, mailings, lawn signs, etc. But I'm also campaigning for 4 council members because we have developed over the last 2 years an outstanding team. We get along. We're very respectful. We don't always agree on everything, but that's fine. I wouldn't expect that different folks would see everything eye to eye. But the difference in the last 2 years as opposed to previous councils, there was a lot of contention, a lot of petty bickering, jealousies, one thing after another. Some of it was very ugly. And we don't have that anymore. We have a very civil, professional council that clearly has the interest of the public and our city at heart. And so I am campaigning for four council people. Myron Frazier, who served as council president the last 2 years. Lloyd Cruz, who has been council president pro tem the last 2 years. Michael Ari Mandelbaum, who took my place on city council and has done an excellent job as a councilman. And we're also supporting the three others and myself are supporting Lenny Taylor, who was just appointed to city council to fill a vacancy. Ms. Taylor has been on council before. She was on the library board. She's been on the planning commission for years. And she's well versed in the issues. Thus she was appointed to fill a vacancy on council. So that's our team. Frazier, Taylor, Cruz, and Mandelbaum, and Ken Seifert for mayor.
People want more information about you or any of these candidates. Where can they go?
Well, we all have candidate committees, and if you Google them, you can find it. Mine is reelect Ken Seifert mayor. Very simple. www.reelectkensivermayor, and I have a website that is up to date with my latest endorsements.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Well, thank you for the opportunity to connect with voters and explain what we're up to. All of the things I mentioned, by the way, are to continue, whether it's roads, redevelopment, business attraction, public art, neighborhood stability, all of these things are going to continue in the years to come.
Great. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.